Okay, children, in the class we have completed up to the do all the sums, about the 10 sums. Now I'm going to do the 3 more sums, so copy down in this. Afterwards we move on to the problems. Okay, now this one is express the division fact. So we can continue. Express the division fact. Express the division facts as repeated subtraction. As repeated subtraction. So you can read how to repeat this one. You can do it easily. So how to do this? 32 minus 4. This is the way of doing the repeated subtraction. So 32 minus 4, you can take the 4 fingers, take the backward numbers. 32 before, 31, 30, 29, 28. So you can put 28, no need to borrow and all. Again you can put minus 4. So 28 before, take the 4 fingers because you are going to minus only the 4. 32 divided by 4, 32 in the 4, 4 bar answer number minus panite. We can get the answer how many times, okay? Here we can write how many times. So 28 before number is 27, 26, 25, 24. So you can put 24. Then again minus 4. So take the 4 fingers. Say the before numbers 23, 22, 21, 20. Then again 4. So 20 means 19, 18, 17, 16. Then 4. That gives you 12. Then 12 minus 4 is 8. So in the 8 and I go for a continuity. 8 minus 4. 8 minus 4 is 4. Then 4 minus 4 is 0. So 0 would stop on it. This is 1 time. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 and 8. So 8 times is the answer. Okay. Now write the division fact of. Write the division facts. So you have to write the division fact of. One into four is equal to four. Dash dash two dash kudukuren. 4 divided by 1, that is equal to 4. Again 4 divided by 4, that is equal to 1. Then the next one is 3 4s are 12, that is dash dash. So you take out this 12, first it divided by 3, that gives you 4. Then again same 12 eduthukonga, 4 let divide pannunga, you get the answer is 3. Okay, so these are the 12 sums for this. From this we'll ask the any numbers. Okay, now we will move on to the problem. Answer the any two sums. Answer the following. First one, arrange the now. Arrange the following. Arrange the following in chronological order. What is that? Chronological order. Okay. So in this chronological order, I'll give the sum like this. Started walking. So na pakat pakat la ezhudivan comma potu. Neenga vande edhu first varano, edhu second varano da kile kile ezhudano. I'll say this. First is started walking. Next one the bath. And next one is started schooling. Started schooling in class 1. Started schooling in class 1. Studying in class 3. Studying in class 3. Then studying in class 2. Studying in class 2. So in the chronological order, எது first வரணும்? Here I given started walking, after birth, after started schooling in class 1, studying in class 3, studying in class 2. So first எப்போமே என்ன வரும்? Birth பிறந்தாதான் இது பண்ண முடியும். Birth first வரணும், அப்புறம் started walking, அப்புறம் நடக்க ஆரம்பிக்கும், அதுக்கப்புறம் ஸ்கூல் ஸ்டடிங் இன் ஸ்டார்டட் ஸ்கூல் இன் கிளாஸ் 1 வரணும், ஸ்டடிங் இன் கிளாஸ் 2 அண்ட் கிளாஸ் 3. ஸோ அதை நீங்கள் கீழே கீழே 1 by 1 எழுதணும். எழுதுன இடம் பார்த்தோமா, ஓகே. ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் பர்த், நம்பர் 1. செகண்ட் ஒன் இஸ் ஸ்டார்டட் வாக்கிங், என்ன எழுதணும்? கீழே தான் 1 by 1 தான் எழுதணும், பக்கத்து பக்கத்தில் எழுதக்கூடாது ஆன்சர் எழுதும்போது. ஸ்டார்டட் வாக்கிங். அண்ட் தேர்ட் ஒன் ஸ்டார்டட் ஸ்டடிங் இன் கிளாஸ் 1. ஸ்டார்டட் ஸ்டடியிங் இன் கிளாஸ் 1. ஓகே, திஸ் இஸ் த தேர்ட். அண்ட் ஃபோர்த் ஆர்டர் எது வரும்? ஸ்டடியிங் இன் கிளாஸ் 2. ஃபஸ்ட் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட்க்கு அப்புறம் இந்த கிளாஸ் வரும், செகண்ட் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட். ஸோ ஸ்டடியிங் இன் கிளாஸ் 2, தென் ஸ்டடியிங் இன் கிளாஸ் 3, ஸ்டடியிங் இன் கிளாஸ் 3. ஓகே, ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த வே டு ரைட் த ஆன்சர் ஃபார் திஸ் கொஸ்டின். After this is the question. Can you understand? Now, the next one is, prepare your bill. So, prepare a bill for the items purchased in the given chart. Prepare your bill for the items purchased. Purchased in the given chart. So I am giving the price of the first one is pen. Pen rupees 20 rupees. Pen order rupees on the 20. Then pencil. Pencil is rupees 10 rupees. Okay. Then third one, chart. That is rupees 5. Then eraser rupees 10 rupees. Eraser is 10 rupees. And the next one is sharpener. Sharpener rupees 5. And then sketch pens. Sketch pens rupees 50. So this is the chart they are given. Now question is, Ramya bought 2 pens. So she is getting 2 pens, 3 erasers. So this is the question. And a sketch pens. And a sketch pen. Prepare a bill for her purchase. Prepare a bill for her purchase. Okay, yeah. So in this sum, prepare a bill for the items purchased in the given chart. Okay, this is the question. So in the chart la they are given pen 20 rupees, pencil 10 rupees, chart 5 rupees, eraser 10 rupees, sharpener 5 rupees and sketch pens 50 rupees. So Ramya bought 2 pens. So Ramya is getting how many pens? She bought 2 pens, then 3 erasers and a sketch pen. So in the a sketch pen na, this means 1 sketch pen. Now we have to prepare a bill for this. Okay, so do the sums, children. Do it and see. Very easy only I give. So now we have to prepare the answer. So in this sum, we have to prepare a chart. So how to prepare a chart like this? We have to write serial number. So you can put it like this. Okay. Serial number, items, then rate. What is, how much is the rate in rupees? Then quantity, QTY is the quantity, how much you are getting, buying, and then price in rupees. Price in rupees. Okay. So you did not chart paper. So first Ramya enna vandranga? She got pens. So item la pens podunga. How many rate is rupees? 20. Evlo quantity vangranga? 2 vangranga. So pens she got it. 2 pens, 2 quantity podunga, rupees vandu 20. So 20 into 2, that gives you 40 rupees. So here you can write rupees 40. Paisel is 00. Then again she is getting second item is eraser. How much is the rupees eraser is? One eraser cost is rupees. How much is it here? Paranga 10 rupees. So in the chart la pathingana theriyum. How many quantities she is getting? 3 erasers. So you put 3. Here 10 into 3. So that gives you 30 rupees. So 30. Okay. And then the third one is your sketch pen. So one sketch pen. Your sketch pen now one. How much is the sketch pen? 50 rupees. So you can write 50 rupees. Only one sketch pen set she is getting. So 150 into 1. That gives you 50 rupees. So rupees 50. Okay, now you have to put the total. So total is, how much is the total? 0, paisa is 0 varum, and here also 0. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 plus 5 is 12. So total rupees is 120 rupees. Okay. So total is 120 rupees. Okay, that's all this one, and we'll move on to the next sum. So can you understand, children? So this is the way you have to see the bill and see the quantity, how much you have purchased, the quantity, everything. Okay, now we'll move on to the next problem. Sum number 2. Yes, bill number is 32. Bill number is 32. Here we'll write serial number, food items, quantity, and then price. Price in rupees. And here the date. They are given the date also. So date anga enna kuduthirukkaangalo and the date podunga. So I am writing this for today, no? So today's date is what? Is 7 or 8? 9/4/2021. Now in this serial item, here they are given one rava dosai. So they are given rava dosai, quantity is 4 and price is 200 rupees. And then masala dosai, quantity is 4, that is 20 rupees. Puri, sorry, masala vadai, then puri is 6, that gives you 90 rupees, and they are given the total amount. Total amount. So how much it is coming? They are given the total amount also, that is 310 rupees. Okay. Now they are given us a fill up the blanks. Enna kuduthirukanga? You have to write the answer. Name of the restaurant. Name of the restaurant. Oh, Hotel Foods. Hotel Foods. This is the name of the restaurant. So name of the restaurant is Hotel Foods. Okay, yeah. Hotel Foods. Then bill number. What is the bill number? Bill number is 32. Then third one is date of the bill. So na inna date potrken. Avanga inna date kudukranglo. That date you can write. So you written as 9/4/2021. Then total number of items eaten. Total number of items eaten. Evlo saapirukinga? Total number of items is 3. 1, 2, 1, 3. Okay. Then fifth one. Total amount of money. Total amount of money to be paid. Evlo pay pannirko number? 310 rupees. So you have to write from this bill, you have to see and write everything. Okay. So I will give this as a chart and you have to see this chart and write everything, children. Okay, yeah. So the name of the restaurant, bill number, date of the bill, and total number of items eaten also you have to write. And now we'll move on to the next sum. The third sum. Write the days of the week. Write the days of the week. So you can write Sunday, then Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So all this you have to write the spelling correctly. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Okay, children. So from these sums, I can give the any two sums or three sums like this. So all the sums you have to write down in the classwork and copy down everything what all I have given. Days of the week, correct, 7 days, correct, no, don't change it and write. And this one also, see this number, I mean see the name of the Hotel Foods. So name of the hotel, you can write, this is the answer you have to, name of the restaurant, I will give it as a dash, and the bill number you have to see, and the date of the bill, which date we are going to put, okay, and then the total number of items eaten, and the total amount of to be paid. So all this you have to see this chart and write, and this one is write the days of the week, and then one more is, and in the last one is write the seasons, months of the year, you know. Okay. So all this you can copy down. So we have finished writing the revision for the third standard. So go through the sums, do the sums and see. Copy down everything in your classwork. Okay, children. Thank you.